the 16th of April. You got to see a snippet of my conversation that I had with my brother all the way, no, when I was taken to the bus station this morning. I'm on my lunch break right now, so I'm trying to eat and talk and drive all at the same time. I feel that I did well for my brother, you know that? I feel like I did a good job at being a big sister. I don't think I did as well as what my dad could have done for him, for example, but I did well under the circumstances that I'm in, where I felt intimidated by him. I felt manipulated by him. I felt emotionally abused. I guess that's the same as manipulation. I was tired of him before he even came up here, because I feel that his same attitude is just 10 times worse than my husband's. And the only reason why I'm fed up with my husband's is because he's been giving me the same crap for 12 years. I'm just tired of it. Anyway, this video's about my husband, not about my brother. But what I was gonna say is, I mean, my brother, not about my husband. What did I just say? I don't feel emotionally healthy to take on my brother and his bullshit. I know I'm not. I can barely handle my husband and me, but that's a cycle of the same bullshit words, same bullshit pattern, same everything. So to add a whole new set of bullshit, but the same same melody, different lyrics, that's all. I mean, really, he was doing the same crap that my husband does to me, but just using different words, using different scenarios. So anyways, what I was saying is I felt like I did my best, and I stayed relatively calm and didn't get emotional this morning. If you noticed, I talked exactly like that the entire time. Now, we get all the way to the Glendale Greyhound bus station, and his bus was canceled. So I had to take him to even further to the Buckeye Road location, which was 17 miles away, and spend another half an hour with him or whatever. And he stopped complaining and bitching, and I know he was upset, probably almost crying, if not actually crying. And I gave him some stuff to read about learned helplessness. I also gave him some stuff to read about victim mindset, and I also told him that he had a lot of good to offer this, and I really want to build on this bonding that we've got an opportunity to do. And that's not going to be just one-sided. That needs to come from both of us. But he's stuck. He's stuck in his bullshit. And I know how that is. I know what it feels like to be stuck in the bullshit. So I told him, if you want to rip up that stuff I gave you, I totally understand. Because if you're at point A and you need to get to point B, regardless on how short the distance is or how long the distance is, you still have to travel the road to get there. And if you don't understand what I'm trying to contribute to your journey, right? If you're not ready to hear it, if you're not wanting to hear it, that's not going to help you get to your destination. But if you want it and you're ready and you're willing, then take it in. My mom talking to me about meditation and bullshit and stuff like that, that doesn't help me when I'm over here at point A. So I don't feel that she needs to talk to me about that. Now, if my journey one day includes meditation, and that's part of my healing that I'm doing, then I probably would love to talk to her about it at that time. So I understand and respect that if he's not ready to take me. I tried to go as far back as I can go when I remember feeling like a victim, when I remember feeling helpless. And I go there quite often, but I'm aware. And so I feel like I'm the closest person that can help him on his next few steps. Because I feel like I'm aware enough to know what it feels like and remember how I get myself out. But I still might be a little too far ahead of the map, of the roadmap, for him to recognize that I might have something valuable to contribute if he would just be willing to listen. And I can't do anything. I can't force him to listen. I can't force him to agree with me. I can't force him to change. And I don't think I need him to change. I don't need him to. I even told him, this is, you know, I have a 19-year-old stepson who we used to be really close and everything, and now he's just doing his own thing and he blames his dad, he blames everything. I don't know how to help him. And if the way I want to help him is not what he needs to speak up and say, no, that's not what I need, this is what I need. And therefore, I can try to be a better support system, but if he doesn't communicate, then I can't. And I said that example to my brother. I said, you are the pilot of your own plane. If you need a nap, you need someone to help you out, you need directions, you want some advice, you need a cup of coffee, you want something, you need to speak up and say so. Otherwise, you are the captain of your own plane and pilot of your own plane, and you can do it how you want. I love that analogy. That analogy really spoke to me. So anyways, I'm gonna go back to work. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.